Aaron wanted to look just like his daddy, so he let his hair get long. Only then he started to have problems. If he combed his hair up, his hair flipped down. If he combed his hair down, his hair flipped up. If he combed his hair over, his hair flipped under. If he combed his hair under, his hair flipped over. One day, while Aaron was combing his hair, he got so mad that he yelled, "Hair! I hate you!" That hurt the hair's feelings. It jumped off Aaron's head and ran out of the bathroom. When Aaron came downstairs, his mother said, "Aaron, you're bald! What happened?" "My hair ran away," said Aaron. "I got mad at it, and it ran away." "This is terrible," said his mother. "Go catch it." So Aaron ran out the door, and his mother went to pick up the baby. She noticed that the baby had a lot of hair. "Aaron," she yelled, "I found your hair." But when Aaron ran back inside, the hair jumped over his head and ran out the door and down the street. So Aaron chased it down the street. After a while, he came to a lady who was yelling and screaming, "Help! Help! Help! Help!" "What's the matter?" asked Aaron. "Look at my tummy," said the lady. "This hair came running down the street, and now it's growing on my tummy." "It does look a little strange," said Aaron. "Make it go away," said the lady. "Just tell it to get off," said Aaron. "Tell it you don't like it," the lady yelled. "Hair, I hate you!" The hair jumped off the lady, ran down the street, and Aaron ran after it. Next, Aaron came to a man who was running around in circles, yelling, "Help! Help! Help! Help!" "What's the matter?" said Aaron. "Look at me," said the man. "This hair came running down the street, and now it is growing on my behind." "It does look a little strange," said Aaron. "Make it go away," yelled the man. "Just tell it to get off," said Aaron. "Tell it you don't like it." The man yelled, "Hair, I hate you!" The hair jumped off the man, ran down the street, and Aaron ran after it. Aaron chased it all the way to the middle of downtown, where there was an enormous traffic jam. A policeman was screaming, "Help! Help! Help! Help!" Aaron went to the policeman and said, "That's my hair." "Your hair," said the policeman. "This hair came running down the street, ran up my back, started growing on my face. I can't see a thing. I'm supposed to be directing traffic, and everything is all jammed up." "Right," said Aaron. "What a mess. 10 cars, 9 motorcycles, 8 trucks, 7 buses, 6 baby carriages, 5 skateboards, 4 bicycles, 3 ambulances, 2 fire trucks, and 1 train. "And my face," said the policeman. "This hair is growing on my face." "It does look a little strange," said Aaron. "Make it go away," yelled the policeman. "Just tell it to get off," said Aaron. "Tell it you don't like it." So the policeman yelled, "Hair, I hate you!" The hair jumped off the policeman's face and ran into the pile of cars. "Oh, no," said Aaron. "Now I'll never find it." Just then the police chief came up and said, "What's going on? Everything is all jammed up. But who put the hair on the statue?" "Statue," said Aaron. "The statue in the fountain," said the police chief. "The one you kids are always messing around with. Get that hair off the statue." So Aaron climbed up the statue and almost caught the hair, but it ran away, and Aaron chased it all the way home, and then he couldn't find it at all. At dinner, Aaron said, "I'm bald forever. I wish my hair would come back. I like my hair." And the hair jumped off the father's head where it was hiding, onto the table, ran over the mashed potatoes and peas and chickens, and jumped back onto Aaron's head. "Fantastic," said Aaron. "Now if I can just grow a beard, I'll look like Daddy." "No problem," said the hair. And it went on Aaron's chin, just like it was a beard. And that's the end of that story.